How do you upsell on eBay?
So follow-up emails, I use 3D sellers. There's a lot of different programs to do it. You can manually do it through the legacy feedback profile.
Okay.
That's a great tip. If you are a smaller seller, use the legacy feedback profile. It's the old one where there's a stack of like 50, you know, purchases and sales, and it'll show whether or not you've left them feedback, they've left you feedback. You can click through to the user's account, and then you can send them a message, and you're not gated per day because you have a transaction. So you can mass message 50 people, or you can use a third-party service like 3D sellers.
3D sellers.
Yeah, and there's a bunch of other ones out there. That's just the one that I've used. It's great. If you're doing 20K a month, it's like $800 a year.
So is it similar to like a autoresponder,
yep,
like ConvertKit or AWeb or something
like that? Yeah, absolutely. If you're getting bigger, like those sorts of things, it's got a bunch of other stuff integrated into it too. There's a lot of really great tools out there. But in this specific case, it's gonna be the auto reminder for feedback. And in there, you send a coupon. You're like, you know, take 10% off your next order. Mention this, take 15% off your next order. I just got this hot new item in. It's really great. MSRP is $79.99. Special price for you, $20 each, two minimum. You know, here's the link, make an offer.
And you know what they say about acquiring customers versus making more sales? It's always the hardest to acquire a customer. It's the most expensive. It's the hardest thing to do, but it's actually extremely easy to sell to a customer who's already purchased from you, considering that you provided a good experience.
You should always be doing follow-up emails
with
your customer.
Can you see analytics? Sorry to interrupt you. Can you see the analytics in terms of, are the emails actually producing revenue?
Oh, yeah, yeah. They're bumping up the watches. They're bumping up views. And I see a lot of repeat customers. An extreme example, a guy in Japan bought a bike for $400 plus $400 shipping, USA-made Trek collectible item. From me, follow-up email, and then I put my cell phone number in there. He called me from foreign, like he was using Skype or something, and he was really, really happy, ecstatic with it. And he's like, "Do you have any more? Do you have any more?" So over the course of 3 months, I sold this guy $4,000 of bicycles.
Thank God you had that follow-up email.
Absolutely.
Because there's a chance that he never would have messaged you.
Absolutely. And there's, you know, especially with collectors and enthusiasts, when you are, and I tell people this all the time, become an expert, have a niche. Get really good at a category. Get really good at a subcategory. Really know your stuff. Know the years it was made. Know, you know, be able to accurately describe it really, really well. Because enthusiasts, they kind of know it, and they can tell if you're bullshitting or not. They can tell if you know your shit or not. And if you do, they are gonna have a lot of confidence in you. And collectors are generally willing to spend a lot of money per year on the same sort of thing over and over and over again. And this can be everything from like on the low end, like mugs, to the high end, like art or 40s car parts or whatever. But if you find that niche that you're passionate about, you become an expert in over the course of 5-10 years, product just comes to you. Sourcing is easy. I have 3,000 bikes, I only have 1,000 listings. The bottleneck is getting it up for me. Like, and it just comes to me, I don't go out and source anymore. And the opportunities for upsells and the opportunities for customer retention are gonna be huge when you're a specialist in an area and you really know your product.
Nobody talks about this stuff, especially upsells and email marketing for eBay. Nobody on YouTube, and I think you guys on YouTube, comment below, say nobody taught us this. I've never heard about anybody. I've heard about it because I do a lot of internet marketing, affiliate marketing as well, so I understand upselling and all of that, and especially like with Shopify stores, it's easy to kind of incorporate all together, but that's huge. That's a really big tip.